Card Zero, Echoes of the 99, by August Servant, Volume 1. Lecture number 10, on the subject of reparations. Identity crisis. The scale is pretty straightforward. Biracial, mixed race, Oreo, high yellow, red bone, etc. The fact of the matter is, if you're not bitter, then you're not black. And the primary reason why these diversionary tactics are so commonly deployed is because for some, it is the only way that they can feel comfortable in their own skin. And the tragedy of it is, this is a learned response ingrained in the psyche of every black citizen living within the borders of these United States. The heart of the matter. If you ask me, black folk and white police will never get along. Not truly. Because the police just possess too much power to be as careful as they are gentle with my people. My experience with the police and most authority figures growing up was, when you see them, run. To say that nothing ever good came from or with the presence of cops. And from my perspective, they were either messengers of death or agents of the Grim Reaper himself, all dressed up in blue. Looking back, as a youth, when you first learned to read, you begin to see meaning in everything around you, as the words written on this or that sign beg for your attention. And in speaking for myself, I always saw it as a badge of honor to be able to look up or out and see a new word to decode for meaning and a deeper understanding. Liquor store and laundromat. Those were my first two words gifted to me from my small little world. And understanding came easy for me once I learned to attach my experience in those places with the actual meaning of the word or words displayed on the signage out front. Now then, imagine my surprise, if you will, when, as a youth, being thrown up against a police car for no other reason than not being fast enough to escape capture, only to read the words "to protect and serve" clearly displayed on the door of the police car. While I'm thinking, even as I'm being harassed and roughly touched, what the hell is that supposed to mean? You're not serving me right now, and the last thing I feel is protected. Understand, my experience with cops has never been without anxiety, and it is because of those deep-seated feelings that I say, while I do not hate the police, I just feel more comfortable when they are not around. Because in my experience, there are two types of cops. Useless and dirty. And frankly, I'd rather not chance upon either one of them. Today, in the real world. Consider, if you will, with the power structure of the police being at the lowest end of the scale of hierarchy, we can now get a clearer picture of just how insignificant the issue of race relations is regarded in the eyes of government agencies and officials. And if we're speaking candidly, with a lifetime of experience in dealing with racists and bigots, both in the civil sector and in the military as well, I can clearly see nothing but an uphill battle for equal justice, rights, and liberties in this country. A failed experiment. Most people don't know this, but a reparations program was tried before, compliments of General Sherman, who issued Special Field Order No. 15 in 1865, thereby confiscating Confederate land in Savannah, Georgia. And as a result, thousands of black refugees who had followed Sherman's army during the tail end of the Civil War were given 40 acres and a mule from the U.S. Army surplus. And for a time, just a few months to be specific, black recipients worked the land and raised livestock. But after President Lincoln was assassinated and Andrew Johnson became the 17th president, he immediately deployed the might and overreach of the U.S. military to seize all the land that was given to the freed slaves and to evict all black occupants. And if you don't know, they were given no compensation for their labor on the land and no hope of recovery, even as their properties were being returned back to white Confederate landowners, while at the same time, the whole legislative event and experience was being scrubbed from the history books. The legacy of this nation. This country always does the right thing after it has exhausted every other approach. And even then, any laws passed are only as lasting as the term limits of the current president in office. Furthermore, to add insult to injury, this nation then goes on to allocate huge portions of its national defense budget to funding the various ways and means of covering up its own mistakes and burying its darkest secrets. But the thing is, you cannot erase history, because her archive is a living and breathing record stored across millions of human minds, starting from the first victims. In just one example, it took this nation from 1776 to the year 1990 to amass a record of 1 million people imprisoned since its founding. And only 10 more years, from 1990 to 2000, to double that amount to a whopping 2 million souls imprisoned. With the takeaway here being, the lion's share of those incarcerated were not white. Lessons in time. Today, the same as yesterday, my black people are still begging, fighting, and dying for peace, justice, and equality, even after this nation has shown us in their own civil wars and capital riots that they have no problem killing and sacrificing their own to forward the most prominent ideology or cause of the time. Blood in, blood out. Each generation before us, going back over 400 years, have paid their pound of flesh. And even as we bleed out in these streets of the current day, we have earned our exit, albeit we no longer have any other place to call home. Still, black people in this country have forgotten the fact and accepted the fable, in that we have become so accustomed to crooked thinking that we are afraid of straight thinking. So accustomed to bondage that we actually fear freedom. We are living out of our element, and as a result, nothing turns out right, with the basic reasoning being that which is in the seed will always come out in the plant. Thus, from 1619 until now, we have been teaching and ingraining in the minds of our children to embrace the concept of inferiority when in the company of whites, and to display deference and false courtesy as not to offend them or come off as hostile. But the thing is, courtesy is the unseen chain that stays our hand, even when we know that we should act. And how are the unseen chains of fear any different? We have been conditioned to be seen and not heard, to take what is given without complaint, and to beg and borrow instead of doing for ourselves. We are content with change by the inch, while they stride at their leisure, miles ahead of us, both secure and confident in the knowledge that we can and will never be able to catch up to them. And in this, they are right. Yet, you still cry out for reparations, as if the damage done to our ancestors and us could be so easily rectified. You may as well hold a candle in the rain and beg for a match to light it. The reason being, we have been so severed from our roots that the scars we bear are generations deep. Moreover, our DNA has been so twisted and manipulated that our own distant families from across the ocean no longer share a likeness or kinship to us. thereby leaving us unrecognizable and thus unclaimed. Meanwhile, here on these shores, our defects, our problems, and our sickness are the result of a mental fixation and hunger for an American dream that will never become our reality, even as we see it in others that are propped up for show and work towards it night and day. With the irony of it being, it is the wanting what we cannot have that kills us little by little every single day as we yet remain in captivity, in a manner of speaking. The way home. Leave open the cages long enough, and the animals of the zoo will depart. Leave open your front door long enough, and any household pet will take their leave. Are we, as a people, not better than the beasts of the field? Do we not deserve our freedom, after 400 years removed from our ancestral home? And if not, then when? How many more generations of our people will remain forfeit in this nation as you quibble and beg for one inch of dignity at a time? Too much energy is wasted trying to prove to others what you already know, and we will never be worthy of equality while living hostage in a house that is not our own. And this is not hate speech, but wisdom. Now then, the only thing my people need to be fighting for in one voice is a mass exodus at this country's expense. Only this is righteous judgment, and the fact that we will be able to leave in peace would be an honorable mercy on both sides. I say, don't ask for reparations. Instead, ask for a passport complete with free and safe passage to a land exempt from U.S. authority. Because at the end of the day, there is nothing that this country can legally do towards the furthering of our advancement that can't be undone by the next incoming administration. I want to say to my people, wake up. But most claim to be woke. And these are those who want nothing more than to be seen, treated, and declared as equal to the beast. But that is not our legacy, nor our destiny. Furthermore, we will never have a legacy of our own as long as our labor and intellectual wealth continues to be devalued and stolen by the laws and ideology of the same oppressor that is still holding us hostage to this very day, as we yet remain bowing and begging for the scraps from a table that we built. No, I am not racist. However, I am a historian of sorts. And the fact is, until we finally learn where we belong and get there, we will forever be lost as a people in an endless cycle of history repeating, while failing to realize that our history is how we move forward, by traveling through it, checking our progress with our past, careful not to repeat it, while at the same time using it as the measure to see just how far we have come. And this one step forward, two step back approach, depending on the administration in office, will do nothing but make both sides increasingly agitated, and rightly so. The continued erosion of our government. Question: how many people have this nation burned and continue to hold to the torch? Take a good and hard look around. The stability of this nation is wavering, and the security we once felt as a superpower can no longer be. Not when the good taxpaying people of this country has to literally wait around for the next tell-all book to drop before learning what is actually going on in the White House and this government as a whole. At some point, you're going to have to come to terms with the fact that the writing is on the wall, especially when the new normal is to lie to everyone until someone is willing to pay you top dollar for the real truth. Where we now have prominent people in government office choosing to trade fame on their way out of a burning White House, as they transition into a new career field, even as they are guilty of arson. Reality check. What my people need to understand is that this country is theirs to destroy. And our part is to simply get out of the way in time. And you can hear me now or believe me later. But the fact is, while your innocence is obvious, it will not save you. As in, when the ship goes down, everybody gets wet, even the rats. And it only gets worse if you cannot swim, because there is no room in the lifeboats for the rats. All this to say, there are the stories that we tell ourselves, and then there is the truth. And the fact is, guilt by association is a real thing. Just ask the rats on the sinking ship. Therefore, how can anyone be okay with aligning his or her identity and fate with a nation that has so much blood on their hands, to include the slaughtering of their own ancestors? Lastly, just as the horse goes before the cart, wisdom precedes forgiveness. And what this suggests is that the wise man is where danger is not. Selah. The Warrior's Creed. If the greatest warrior among you cannot also be mistaken for a monk or priest by those unaware of his battle prowess, then he is not fully formed, for his mind is not yet balanced with the physical discipline of his body. Example. My martial arts instructor once asked me, "Why do you wish to practice the arts?" To which I replied, "I want to be so good that I never have to actually use it against anyone." Power or truth in repose or at rest will look like anything other than itself. Example. According to modern science, there are 118 elements of chemistry in the periodic table. But contrary to popular belief, in truth, there is only one element, hydrogen. And every other element that follows it, today and tomorrow, are just multiple faces of the same element added against itself. With the takeaway here being, understand that creation is done. God took care of that already. Man's part is simply to discover and then learn how to apply new ways and means. To say that God left it to man to name it, not to claim it. Look at it like this. If thought and hydrogen were one in the same, then every idea that could ever be imagined would simply be the byproduct of thought. Just as every element that ever was and ever will be is a byproduct of hydrogen. My creed. Like my mother, nature, my wrath is as terrible as my mercy is sweet. And as my father, earth, I am as timeless and immortal as the truth that made me. Question. What qualifies as a sane response in a world full of madness? Example. A typical job amounts to a waste of energy attempting to prove to others what you already know, while being paid less than a livable wage. Thus, one should aim for a partnership or to simply go into business for themselves. And it is with this in mind that I say, another word for outlaw is entrepreneur. Because either way, you're going into business for yourself, with the only difference being the amount of risk involved, speaking in terms of a worst-case scenario situation. In the words of Dean Alfang, "I will not cower to any master, nor break against any threat. It's my heritage to stand erect, proudly, and unafraid, to face the world boldly and say, "This I have done." Dialogue. It's not safe out there. Is it ever? Better the danger in front of me than that which is hidden. See, that's the kind of attitude that will get you into trouble and a world of hurt. Yeah, well, I'd rather be effective than careful. Waiting for something unexpected to happen robs you of the momentum needed to push through. The unknown is nothing to be feared, but respected. And you do this not by tiptoeing, but by boldly going forth to answer what awaits on the other side of the door. Look at me. This is supposed to be tough. Now, as to the pain and discomfort that you are feeling as a result, well, that part is optional. God. 1. Don't magnify the problem. Magnify God, and the solution will be made known. 2. As God is my rock, I am unmoved by appearances, and therefore, appearances move. 3. Act as though I were, and I am. Scripture. 1. Psalms 77:4. Thou holdest mine eyes waking, my thoughts thinking, my tongue speaking, my hands and heart, even as I perform. I and thee are one. 2. Psalms 56:13. For thou hast delivered my soul from death. Would not thou deliver my feet from falling, that I may walk before God in the light of the living? 3. Isaiah 36:4. So saith the Lord, I have counsel and strength for war. What confidence is this wherein thou trustest that you would rebel against me? I submit to you. Be worthy. Please allow me to introduce myself. You can call me August Servant, and it is a privilege to bring to you my captured Echoes of the 99 by way of Card Zero, The Fool.